views about national conference has not changed a bit. I still hold the view very seriously that the national conference is going to end up a jamboree, as I said earlier on, many months ago. I still hold the view that the presidency is merely using the national conference as an instrument of diversion. I stand by that. I also stand by my statement to the fact that the presidency or the president, as the case may be, is just using the national conference also to cause division among some of the big political elites in the Southwest so that he can make some penetration as far as the votes of the people in that region are concerned. I stand by that as well. But you see, the truth of the matter is that if you read my statement, I said also that despite of all of this, I have no problem with any platform or any conference where people are going to be asked to discuss Nigerian problems. There's nothing wrong in discussion. Our people should engage that process. In fact, it would be wrong for people of my tradition not to engage the process for whatever it is worth. The idea being that you go there and even use the conference to expose further the contradictions of the ruling system. Because if my people go there, I imagine that the kind of thing they're going to be doing there is not to go there and speak flowery Queen's English, but it's to go there and make it very clear that the way Nigeria is structured is wrong. And so when we say Nigeria must be restructured in our own parlance, if you like, we're not saying that, oh, let's look at ethnic issues, give this Yoruba, this give outside. No. It is the ruling class. That is the language. It's not our language. Of course, we know that there are secondary issues of, you know, ethnic rivalries here and there. But it's not primary. In the sense that the basic restructuring that we call for, that we think we need, is to restructure Nigeria economically among the ruling classes. Among the classes generally. In other words, you cannot have an equitable economic system where the majority of the people live in abject poverty, where the majority of the people cannot afford to eat decent meal. One decent meal, I'm not talking about 3 square meals as they used to say in those days. We're not talking about the country where people who are ill cannot access the medical system and they then die of all sorts of opportunistic diseases in their homes or to take all sorts of concussions which complicate their problems. They have kidney problems there and there now, liver problems. We're talking about, you know, how to change that system so that every Nigerian will have access to medical care. And the way to do that is to fundamentally rupture the existing system of economics in Nigeria, if you like, if that will make it clear. I don't want to talk about relations of production now. So, now having said this, my view is that, yes, let them talk at the national conference, but the real national conference itself that will change the problem of this country, that will solve the problem of this country, I mean, is not the one that is going to be convened in the comfort of a presidential office or the office of the secretary of the government. It's a conference that is going to be convened right on the street there. And that conference cannot be convened or convoked, as the case may be, without that gigantic organization that I said we need to bring about. It is that organization that will unite the masses, the workers, the peasants, and the market people. And then, of course, the headquarters, the venue of that conference is on our streets. We need to reclaim our streets. But we can't reclaim our streets if we also abandon, if we don't engage the national conference that is going to be held in a very large hall that is air-conditioned, where people are going to be serving tea and coffee, people are going to be collecting allowances. And you know, I said it then, that they should not use our resources for all the delegates. If anybody wants to go and take part in the national conference, let the person fund his or her way to that place. If you like, and go and stay in the best hotel in Abuja, that's your business. But we can't be using the resources that people have almost stolen to nothing to also take care of a talk shop. I think that would be a historic waste of resources. So I am not opposed to people going there. People should go there, but at the end of the day, nothing is going to come out of it, because make no mistake about it, they want to take the outcome of that conference again to the National Assembly. When the National Assembly is already amending the constitution, there's a process. They'll be spending billions. So it's actually bordering on the irresponsible to be spending public resources this way. But we'll see how it goes. I hope to be I hope not to be vindicated, because it will be very bad if actually I am vindicated.